It's an inevitable mixed bag of emotions. It sort of feels quite sad to let go of Sydney because he feels like a wonderful friend, and I've spent the last few years fleshing him out and understanding him and learning to love him, and now it's like saying goodbye to a friend and saying goodbye to the relationships which he has with Geordie. And obviously most importantly, and sort of what's most sad about it, is saying, I mean, I'm not saying goodbye to these people, but inevitably I'm going to spend a lot less time with people like Tess and Al and Robson, who are just the best. I can say honestly, hand on heart, Robson Green is one of the best human beings I've ever met. And I hope he didn't hear that. But he's a very, very special individual. And so it's always an absolute pleasure and privilege to be allowed to mess around with him for 4 months.
When people ask about Grantchester, the public, or when I'm stopped in the street or wherever, every single time, bar none, they all ask the same question: what is it like working with James Norton? And it is not work. It has had a profound effect on my life. And when I'm with James, life's just a bit better, and you live it a bit better, and you smile just a bit bigger. Whatever space he inhabits, he lights it up, you know, it's a better place.
I can't quite believe that it's the final days of James being here and Sydney being here. It's just, I think I'm not thinking about it. I don't want to think about it, and I will pretend that he's still here when I come back.
It's weird. It's really strange because we all started together and, you know, we've become really good friends, like a little family, and you know, and everyone who comes in enjoys doing the show because it is a really nice group of people. And James was the head and the leader of that, and he was a great leading man.
I'm sad that he's going to be going, but I think it's also, I'm a great believer in new life and new forms, and I think sometimes that can bring an energy, and you can discover new things through that.